So that being said, Lord willing this happens, I want his casket to be there. I'm going to bring him back after my son, Wake the Dead. I want his robot, or however we choose to do this stuff, to talk about his faith and his love for the military.
I've been working on this for the last couple hours, trying to figure out what the hell's going on here. I've got this guy Caspian, Caspian. This shows up at the top of my thing every now and then. I went into a search to search for Caspian in my followers. He's not one of my followers, but he's on TikTok. So, whatever's going on, Caspian keeps showing up in the top of this. I'm going to try to get it and show it to you here in a second. But I don't know why he keeps showing up. I went to his site. It just shows his face on top of a thing. It says something about effects. Blah, blah, blah. So maybe he's the effects guy to TikTok. These are his effects or something. But other than that, I would assume he's the one messing with my stuff. He's the one that keeps showing up. He shows up at the top up here. All right. But I ain't seen it for a minute. But I looked him up the last time I got it up there. I can't, if I go much further, it'll take my original sound out again. Tells me that there's a song on it. I don't see it. This stuff is driving me crazy, you guys.
All right.
I needed help. From somebody at church, somebody that knows something. I'm done going to church. I'm not going to church again. You guys, I cannot believe how bad I got screwed out of this stuff. I feel like you're all spending my money. Even Joe, when he was talking about 10% from Snickers, I swear you guys are gonna hijacked my gig, and you're going to put somebody else in the middle of it. So, that being said, Batter, Shamas, have at it. You be Melchizedek, you fucking bunch of fucking retards. I'm done with this crap. Good luck, Lindsay Lohan. I hope you're married to that guy, and I mean it. A fucking bunch of shit. Yeah, I didn't finish my story in that last video that I was making. 1997, that girl that I was dating. I can't tell you how many times after that I said I couldn't afford to be wrong. You know what happened in 1997? We fell short after a couple dates. She told me, and then I caught her lying about this guy at work that she had filed a sexual harassment suit against. I worked at the same place with this girl. After a few minutes of talking to her about it, I realized she was lying. And I didn't know what to say. And I thought, oh my gosh, well, I just moved this gal into my house. And to get her out of a situation she was in, her dad grabbed her by the hair and took her to church one day and made her scamper like a spider. At least that's what her sister said. This girl named Julia that was working at Bowers. Well, anyways, make a long story short, she told me she was pregnant when she wasn't. Some kind of parent trap, you think? Shortly after that, I got real specific about my wife, and I was really slamming the Lord with prayer and telling him how bad I can't afford to be wrong. You know what I like? That was my short prayer. The long prayer was at Grand Rapids School of Bible and Music, and it always ended with a salute. 5-5. I joked with him, and I told him I like to go down on him when I kiss him. It made me laugh. And I was just being specific because he knows what I like. Red hair, green eyes, freckles, and supermodel. She can change the color of her hair. I kind of like that idea, don't you? I love what women can do with their hair. But it just is what it is. So I had all kinds of freaky prayers to the Lord. I got up in my room that night, walking from the roof to the bed. Once I got in bed, I started laughing. I said, Lord, make him about like that. You know what I like. Like I said, Lindsay Lohan is perfect. You can't make this stuff up. When I was praying for the Detroit Lion football team in the front yard of Grand Rapids School of Bible and Music, she was making commercials with Ford. I didn't know that. When I was going through my crap with this girl, she went right into making the Parent Trap. Kidding me, right? I got a lightning bolt from the Lord and she made the Parent Trap. You know, and one of those movies she was in, they changed the house number to 7. She got a 7 on the back of her neck. She unloaded Speak on the 7th of December when I unloaded my number 7. And I tagged John Lennon's quote with, I wonder which one will go first, rock and roll or Christianity. I tagged it with Resurrection of Jesus Christ. You see, the resurrection of Jesus Christ is the foundation of the church. Without the foundation of the church, our faith is meaningless. That's why I thought that was really something on the 7th, the day before John Lennon died. You want to hear something really crazy? Inside of that 3 weeks as I approached getting my own computer, I was yelling at the Lord. I said, it's a good thing he died on the 8th or I wouldn't do it. People get the wrong idea. And then I started laughing and I said, oh, wait a minute. You know that because you know me. And it made me laugh even harder. So there's a lot going on in these 3 weeks. I wore trails in my yard talking to him, trying to figure out what the hell was going on. Then I get a lightning bolt, and I had to sit on it for 14 years. What is wrong with the church? You know, there's a big part of me that says they did get on board because I'm a classic prodigal son. Well, there's a lot of those out there, but I'm classic when it comes right down to it. Had big dreams, big visions. Wanted to do something special for him, for king and country. And included my wife. I built my life around Lindsay Lohan, and I think when you look at changes and stuff going on in my life and what she was doing, right down to the, what was it, the Nittany Lions and Mean Girls. Again, she was a Ford girl, and it just fits so good. She's perfect for what I wanted to do, and I'm scratching my head saying, looking at him saying, how'd you do that, Lord? I don't know how he did it. And that's why, in my mind, I can't accept the fact that she's married. I can't. I don't understand that for the life of me. And, you know, do I really have to do this? I really don't want to go to heaven. Not doing what I'm convinced he's called me to do. But, you know, when you've done everything you possibly could do, with the brains that you've got, you know, and the doors that you keep running into, or the doors you just keep knocking on. You know, one minute I think everybody's helping me, the next minute I'm here all by myself, so I really don't know anymore. I know I'm the big guy. I feel for Biden. That poor guy should be moving on and along. But I also see it as a bunch of goddamn fake shit. They know I'm here. They're waiting for me. How do I know that? Because we're going to adopt the 12-step program as a one-world religion. Why? Because there's no killing in it. There ain't no reason Catholics, Muslims, Christians, and Jews can't get along. All that race-baiting bullshit that's out there, people pitting each other against each other's religions and claiming that it's religion that caused wars. Man, it's stupid idiots that cause wars, folks. Can't you see that? It's just, war is senseless at this day and age. And I just scratch my head and look at what the governments are up to, and you gotta just scratch your head and say, what the hell is going on? Well, we're gonna have a one world currency. Lindsay Lohan is going to be on the $100 bill. Trump's going to be on the $50 bill. And Goodbye Lucy, the green man Elish, is not only going to be on the Bud Light can, but he's going to be on the $1 bill. I want y'all to be reminded every time that passes your hands that you're going to have to put your trust in Christ, or you, like the left, is going to be left behind. You see, all those Christians that missed the opportunity like Mr. Biden did, and right in front of God and everybody when Bud Light was right in front of him, that was an opportunity the Holy Spirit wouldn't miss. That's simple. That's keeping it simple. The Holy Spirit would have been all over that. So don't tell me you're a believer. That was in front of not only the nation, but in front of the whole world. Made our country look like a weak bunch of fucking sissies. Making bathrooms for creeps like that. Are you fucking that stupid? Really? Boys have a wee-wah. Girls have a hoo-ha. What part of that don't you get? Are you really that goddamn stupid? Making bathrooms for people that are fucking... I got one word for transgender. Retarded. Retarded. You can bring that word back. Anybody that doesn't know the difference between a boy and a girl, you're fucking retarded. Fuck you and the lightning bolt I rode in on. I'm sick and tired of you stupid ass motherfuckers thinking you know something. I've got a lightning bolt and I'm going to put it where the sun don't shine. God doesn't marry same-sex people. Are you fucking that stupid? That one pastor, gay pastor, got hit with a lightning bolt. Oh, that's not God's judgment. How stupid are you? The atheist that got hit with the lightning bolt questioning God, he's got a better off chance of finding Christ than that guy does. Why? Because his mind is gone. You can't tell talking to those people. Who knows what it's going to take to crack that egg open, let the light in. You gotta answer a fool according to his folly, or he'll be wise in his own eyes. Just like the Marshmallow Man coming out and telling everybody that we're going to respect him. Huh? You're going to respect me and my king, buddy. He's the one that died and made me the king. Our identity is found in Jesus Christ. You don't know the difference between a boy and a girl? You're already lost. How sad is that? I read a book that tells me to test the spirits to see whether they're from God or not. And all I have to do now is walk up to somebody and say, hey, man, you know the difference between a boy and a girl? Depends. Well, you know, guys can get pregnant. How fucking stupid are you? Really? The longer I sit on this lightning bolt, the madder I get. I highly recommend if somebody knows something out there that knows what the hell's going on, if you want me to chill out, might be a good idea to do it now. The only way I'm going to really chill out, if I know that girl right there is not married. Because y'all are fucked up there. I don't know if you can see that or not. What am I supposed to tell her? You're kidding me, right? Well, it's God's sovereign will for you. You made your bed, you lay in it. That's what I gotta tell her. This guy right here, don't get married. I know better. You can't make him better than that. I was perfect. Design. There was design behind it. You're going to see it in both our stories, how they mesh. Can't make this stuff up. It is what it is. I'm praying for the Detroit Lions football team, and here's this little girl making commercials for him. What? It's, you know, what, 30 years later, I'm all stuck on her? I'd find this stuff out after I started Googling everything, after I was already in love with her. I'm just so done with the church and people thinking they know what God's will is. On and on that goes, you know. I get it. I do. I've been struggling with God changing my name for 30 years. It is what it is. I get it. That's a hard one to swallow. I can't say it any other way. You know, the night before the lightning bolt, I'm just going to end with this because I'm just frustrated. I need to tell my story. I need to start from the beginning. But the night before that lightning bolt, when I started telling the Lord, I started getting really crazy. And most of the time I was laughing, but when it got serious, it got serious. And when I said, so I'm going to walk in there and say I'm Melchizedek, and I'm referring to the church, thinking that I would be doing something televised at church, you know. I know Radiant has a way to do some of that. I don't know what the Lord was going to do with the lightning bolt after I came running back. That's my point. But the whole gig is, I kept saying, so I'm going to walk in there and tell them I'm Melchizedek for such a time as this. That's what I was saying 20 years ago when I called the pastor up crying at night. I was arguing with him. I don't know how to listen to him. You know, I don't hear audible voices. And I started in thinking he changed my name. And it wasn't something I just picked up. Because it all made sense. I was building a rapture-ready ministry, and to do that, everybody's going to have to give me 10%. I mean, it made sense. So that's why I started taking it, got a little more serious. Wait a minute here. I mean, I was calling it a world ministry. I was going to have to call all the churches together. But when I said it was crazy, next thing out of my mouth was, it's crazy for the sake of God, but because what I say is right and true, that's for you. Now, I don't know about you. Now I'm really spooked, because that's what's happening. See, I don't hear them, but that's coming out of my mouth. You're kidding me. And then I said, well, that's what Paul said. Well, see, Paul said, according to Scripture, if I'm out of my mind, it's for the sake of God, but because what I say is right and true, that's for you. Because a lot of people, like the Muslims especially, think, and they really like to pick Paul apart, but they think we're all crazy because we call Jesus Christ God. That's because he is. It is what it is. And I'm not going to argue with it about it. I'm not going to get all bent on the Trinity. Yeah, I got the Trinity for you. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Come here. Let me give you a holy kiss, you stupid-ass Muslim. That's what it boils down to. Holy Spirit. That's a new sign for the Holy Spirit. Okay? That's what it is. Don't let anybody tell you any difference. Because we can do this and say, let me give you that holy kiss. Because that's our Lord. He wants to give you a holy kiss. His name is Jesus Christ. I got a lightning bolt that says, I'm right, you're wrong, and I don't really care what the rest of you think. That's what it boils down to. Like I said, your book, as well as the Book of Mormon, well, the Jehovah's Witness New World Translation, and a whole bunch of other books. Nothing but a yeast infection that stinks all the way to heaven. It is what it is. There ain't no reason to even read those books anymore when it comes right down to it. And just for the record, 3 weeks, inside of that 3 weeks and the last night, we were hiding Bibles. I don't know why. I don't know why. We were collecting food and water. I don't know why. I've been doing that, putting them in the treatment centers for years and saying it was going to be in concert with the rest of everything else that's going on. Because we got 100 guys in a treatment center. If there was a tornado or something that happened and we got a bunch of food and water, we could be first responders. And I've just been putting this together for years and talking all kinds of stuff to them. And I still can't get anybody to listen. In the end, I wanted a NASCAR. I wanted to call it the Rapture. I wanted a pro amateur tournament with Tiger Woods. I wanted car shows to be going around. I wanted Jay Leno's cars. I wanted, at one time, I just wanted a couple of them. But when they kicked Conan off, I was pointing at him and saying, now I want all your cars, you son of a bitch. And I was yelling at him. Yeah, that's right. You heard me. I wasn't using the colorful metaphors, but I was madder now. I loved Conan. It was fun watching him in the Tonight Show. It was a freaking riot. I don't know why what happened there. Really ticked me off. So then I wanted all his cars. I wanted these car shows to go around and raise money for Olive Cash Ministries. I had all kinds of stuff going on of what I wanted to do. I had 7 days of concerts from the 1st through the 7th in honor of my queen to the glory of my king. It is what it is. The 1st through the 7th of July. That was back the Grand Rapids School of Bible Music. Didn't start painting till 1992. So I started painting, and I was going to add selling paintings. I could sell them for $200 at the art shows. I'd like to sell them to the bigwigs for like what Hunter does. What a bunch of fucking idiots. You'd be putting that money towards some really good stuff, and you guys waste so fucking much money. You make me sick. My gosh, if you would have got putting this money away when I come back, 2010, $1 from everybody every freaking weekend, I could have built that fucking wall myself. Are you kidding me? God, I'm so fucking pissed at you people. Can't you see that? So yeah, I'm sitting on a miracle. Treated like a nobody. Well, I am a nobody. I ain't nobody. Don't care if I'm anybody when it comes right down to it. I don't have to do this. I don't need to. I wanted to because I wanted her. And boy, is that selfish, ain't it? And here I am. And, you know, I am this close to deleting every fucking thing I got. Are you kidding me? When I saw her make a reference to the Truman Show, I just said, you know, fuck you motherfuckers. And that was her and her about her baby having to do something. And I, you know, I'm done with my Truman Show. I'm done with Groundhog Day. Like I said, I don't have to be anybody. It's not my gig. He's going to swallow me up with some kind of fish and drop me off somewhere. I just know it. I just have to be patient. But I'll probably delete everything. Because you know what? You don't get this show on the road here pretty quick. Let me know what the fuck is going on. Then I am fucking crazy. I'm going to just leave it at that. Because I'm going to tell you right now, I didn't studio manipulate that lightning bolt. I didn't put that there. I don't care what the hell all you guys think. I don't really care. I've heard everything from my energy, did it to... I did it myself. Jesus Christ gave it to me. He knows me. And if he knows me, he knows you too. Are you scared yet? Without Jesus, when I die, where I'm going, you cannot come. Sorry. Not sorry.